G'day and welcome back. Faintly Saintly here, and today we're looking at a game called Roguelike. Now this is a roguelite survival game. Basically, as you can see here, it's sort of a top-down, eight-directional sort of deal, where you collect resources and build buildings and things like that, and try and survive the onslaughts of zombies, basically. I've just started this game. I have played one or two quick goes at it, just to get the rough idea of what to do. And basically what we're doing is collecting berries to complete the initial tutorial. There we go. Now it's saying to collect some wood. So it's very reminiscent of games like, Stardew Valley, Harvest Moon, that sort of thing. We walk around, you got your multi-tool, which acts as your axe and pickaxe and that sort of thing. And basically at this stage, you need food to survive each day. And you can see along the top there, I've got four food resources now. And you collect stone, wood, iron, and that sort of thing to build a little settlement, I guess. So as we walk up here, I believe there was a zombie not far away. Combat basics, here we go. Just going to keep chopping on the way there. Here it is, so here is a zombie. On his own, not too much of a threat. Oh, and he did drop a key. And you'll notice that there was a little key door down to the south. Now, what that last little tutorial pop-up was telling us is that I am the knight class, and my special ability is to bring up a shield. And I believe there are three different classes with different abilities. But to start with, you just have the one to choose from. So I'm just going to keep collecting resources and make my way up this little ramp here. Okay. And here we go, a place to call home. So it's teaching me to basically place a campfire. And we'll place it there. And when we put that down, it costs a few resources and a bit of gold, and it will just sit there and build to completion. Now I want a workbench. And that will unlock new construction possibilities. So if you have a look now, I've got a few more things to build. I can build floors, walls, lanterns for extra light, resource storage, doors, and land plots to grow some food. That's not a bad idea, but that costs 40 gold. I've only got 29 at the moment. What I might do is just build this little crate here, because you do have a limit of what you can carry at any given time, and that will slightly increase that. So, let's just defend ourselves here. The combat is a little bit simple, but mostly just does what it says on the tin. There we go. So what do I need for a food patch? I think it was 40 gold, so that might be the next objective for me. So what I've read as well is that you can find NPCs and they can actually come and join your settlement. Similar to what you might see in Terraria, I believe, if you build a place for them to stay. And they can provide different services and resources to your camp as well. But they do cost food to keep, I believe. So every day you lose an extra food or something like that. Okay, so I'm just walking around here collecting some of these resources so we can go back and get building. Ah, okay, you can see there I am full of wood. It's reached 110. I can't carry any more. So let's head back here. Might build. Can build a farm plot. Might be better off using some more crates just to keep me going. And, so since we found that key, I'm actually going to wander back down the the way I came from. And we'll try and unlock that door and see what's behind it. So the roguelite element is that basically death is inevitable. You will die. And when you die, you will start again. From what I understand, the map doesn't change, but you lose all your sort of progress. The meta progression is when you kill zombies, you'll see a little counter in the top right of the screen. That's at currently at 18 kills. That becomes your meta progression currency. Okay, so I've survived. Okay. So rescuing survivors will come back with you and allow you to access more structures. And they can produce resources daily as long as they have enough food. Yeah, so the meta progression is basically you spend the zombie heads, and I believe that will increase your stats and abilities and things like that. Oh, a couple of zombies pop out of the ground. Try not to be overwhelmed when facing multiple enemies at the same time. Okay, so we found some iron there, which is very good. There's a person in there. Can't go in that way. Okay, so my maximum carry weight now is 130 of each resource, so I'm maxed out of stone. So I won't mine anymore. That'll just go to waste. So I make my way around here and see what we find. Another little zombie. It's a little bit funny swinging the weapon up and down rather than left and right. It's you can go sort of down, left, down, right, but never straight down, depending on which way you're facing previously. What is going on in here? It's smashing the walls up. Can you come out of there, please? Righto, they can break down walls. Which probably teaches me something about building the base later. Then I'll never really be 100% safe, I guess. Oh my god. I'm hoping I'll be able to increase my combat ability soon, because this struggles when there's more than one enemy to worry about at a time. Is he going? He is. Okay. Cool. Oh, did I just pick something up? I picked up a club. There you go. A bit slower. Might be a bit stronger. Okay. I don't have another key to get him out. Can I open this chest? No. What's another item? Or was that the key? I don't know. Still no key. Okay. So somehow I need to come back and find another key. Interesting. I don't know if I can do anything with that chest back there. Didn't seem to respond to anything. So where'd I find that first key? I think it was just a random drop, wasn't it? These guys aren't seemingly dropping any. It's good for the gold, but... I'd rather they just cough up a key for me. Doesn't seem to be happening. So we'll have to come back to him. Let's make our way back up. Now my stone and wood are full, so I'll see if I can build a few things, just use up some of that. Might plant my garden now, actually. What is that? Oh, I'm healing, okay. So when you're in the vicinity of your campfire, you slowly recover your health, which is nice. Three little food patches there. We'll see what that does for us. Got a couple more. Oh, no, that's it. Out of money. Alright. So that'll increase my storage quite a bit. Is there anywhere else to go up here? No. So what else can I see? A map. Oh, is that me there? Okay. Maybe. I don't know. Big settlement here, right up to the north. A little farm over there, maybe. Okay, interesting. Alright. Let's go for a wander. Let's see what else we can find. Ah, it's starting to rain. I wonder if that affects anything. Just keep collecting wood as I go. May as well. Okay, it seems to be that the direction you're facing when you start the swing is the direction you'll swing. Ah, okay, and holding down shift is like strafing. That's good to know. A little dodge there. Ah, it does have the controls on the bottom right. There you go. Yeah, that makes things a bit easier. And found another cave. Let's bash this guy and see what's in there. Oh, hello. Oi, have you seen a mining pick around here? No. Did you find my pickaxe? No. Oh. Okay, bottom left, I found a key. You can see it down there next to my L and R button. So, that's good. I can go back and let that guy out now. A great axe. Sounds strong. We'll see. Alright, wood is full. Stone is not yet. What was my ability again? It was a big shield, wasn't it? Do you wonder how useful that'll be? Jesus. Nice. Yeah, I'm... sort of need to bring fights down to a horizontal plane rather than trying to swing up. It's just a bit too awkward. So I'm looking for a pickaxe. That axe is much more powerful. Some iron over there. Definitely want to go get that. Get you out of the way. So I'm yet to see exactly what the meta progression really looks like. Like, I've finished a brief run and died pretty quickly just to get the idea of what the game was all about. But I didn't really get a good sense of how subsequent runs will change So it'll be interesting to see. Because my understanding is the world itself won't change. So if I die, I'll probably be doing this quest again. But in theory, the meta progression makes the quest easier. So you can finish it quicker and progress further. In theory. We'll have to wait and see. Oh, an exit. Okay. It's a bit ominous. Oh, there's a key door there. Doys. Oh, I've got four keys now. May as well use one. So can I open this now with a key? Yes. It's full of gold. Oh, hello. Oh, there we go. So what's behind the door? Ooh, a spiky boy. There's the pickaxe too. Strafe. Just keep the distance. Don't get stabbed. There we go. They're both at once. Beautiful. Alright, a bit more iron for our trouble, which is nice. Found the pickaxe. So I'm curious to see what I can do with the iron as well. Another locked door. I've still got three keys, so why not? I feel like this might just take me back to the main path, which is good. Oh, got some company. Where'd you come from? I suppose I should kill them. They are worth something to me, I suppose. When I inevitably die. Just need to find a way out of here now. Well, one just popped out of the ground. Better put him back in it. Get away. So that one seemed a bit faster and a bit weaker, so there must be some level of variety of zombies. I really just like this awkward vertical fighting. Not quite as smooth as to the left or right. There's a dude over there with a katana. I think he's in my way. Might be a bit stuck. That's okay. Maybe next time, pal. Hey, we've made it out. I need to pay better attention to my health. I didn't realize I was less than half health now. Must have taken a few hits. You found it. Let's be getting a move on. Okay, death is inevitable. And when it comes, you'll be able to use the heads of zombies you have felled to purchase permanent upgrades. Yeah, all resources and structures are reset. There you go. So if I die, I come back. I'm in the same world, but all my progress is basically gone. And we do it again. So, I'm just going to run back to my camp. Just me, or is that rain really loud? Okay, food's coming along. Plenty of money, plenty of everything, really. A deep, dark hole. That's new. Do I want a hole? We'll see. An additional source of light. Too far from light source. There we go. And this just costs gold. I don't know the value of walls and floors just yet. Wonder if I need to think about some more food. These don't cost much. What does this do? Ah, literally just placing. Oh, hello. Hi. Born and raised in Taran's Mill, never left till the Calamity. I was in the mine when the sinkhole opened. Some say it leads to the Hells. Oh. That doesn't sound very nice. Let's get some shelter happening, maybe. Simple wooden wall. Four wood. Where is my cursor? It's going to be funny. There we go. Can't build there. Okay. And a door. Oh no, out of wood. Okay. There you go. We've got a little shelter for whatever reason. What's down this hole? Oh, literally a dungeon entrance. Okay. Get away from me. So did it say there'd be iron in here as well? Oh, is this like a Stardew Valley mine? There's another little ladder down. Quickly check that out. Willow. Get away from me. Got some iron. Grab this wood now. Okay, can't get that wood for some reason. Can't smash that for some reason. Don't know whether I want to be going too far into this right now. Unless it's just to get a bit of iron and get out again. Get you out of the way. Another key. Oh, that's right. I've got to go save that other guy, don't we? Yeah, I'm not going to go down any further at this stage. Get my iron, I'm going to leave. I've got three keys, so I can get back down there and let him out, see what his story is. He might come and join the settlement as well. Alrighty. Cover for a bit. Get a little door there. I think I will look for some more food as well. There we go. All cozy in here now. A grating noise. That's right. I've got a bit of health now. I'm going to make my way back down, see what's in there. What was that? Something happened. Hello? Hello? Tea? Lantern? Uh-oh. I think I'm stuck. Okay. Well. I'm just trying to reload. Okay, that works. I'll give that one more go. This is a weird little bug. I was a bit worried I was going to lose everything, so at least that's not the case. But hopefully it'll let us progress here. So this is still purely just a demo. The full version of the game, I believe, is due to come out in Q4. So it'll be interesting to see what else, how this develops and how this plays out. I think it's got a good... good bones. It's got a good foundation, I suppose. It's fun and the concept's good. A little polish and, you know, a few more features and updates. It could be something really cool. So we're back here again. Got a little friend down there with a sword. Come fight me. Ow. Not like that. Can't get him. What are you doing, buddy? Need to smash that to get out. Okay. I think I do just pick up another item. A spear. A warhammer. Whoa, no time for that. Okay, warhammer. It's slow, but a bit more powerful. The spear seems interesting as well. Bit of longer range, maybe. Just picked up a red thing. No idea what that was. Alright, let's let you out, fella. I'm glad to see you. I thought I'd die here. Anything else you want to add? Oh no, he's gone. Okay, well, we saved him. So, I wonder if we go back, we'll find him in the settlement, making himself useful. I don't mind the spear, actually. That distance is nice to have. Or the range, I should say. Make our way back. Put that lantern away now. So as for the story, I'm not quite sure why I'm a knight. Or what... what era or time this is supposed to have happened in. Thanks for the gold. Wait, that's not the way. Maybe it's just the animation as well, but the spear makes vertical fighting a bit less painful as well. Farming some gold, why not? Up to 72 zombie heads. So I'm very keen to see what that meta progression looks like, but I suppose I'll have to die to find out. Okay, we're back. Ah, so I can probably build something else now, yeah? A workspace for a mason to cut stone. Produces stone daily. Up here out of the way. Oh, there he is. We need a wall put up. Yep. Okay. Oh, here we go. Stone floor, stone wall. Which presumably is going to be a lot more effective than a wooden wall. Too far from a light source. Let's build a little defensive wall, shall we? It costs 5 gold and 8 stone. So I should have a few in me. Can I build out, like... Is this all traversable, or is this a barrier? Seems to be a barrier. Oh, just clicked out of the game. Do it again. Alright, I need to deal with you first. If you could please go away. Hey! Get away from that. Alright, got some walls happening. Too far from light source. There we go. That'll do. So what are you going to do, little zombie? No, you're going to walk straight in? Okay. So I'm assuming that's going to work as a solid boundary. Now this cursor thing's a bit awkward. I'm gonna build a bit of a funnel in. There we go. Use up all my stone, but then hopefully zombies will just be funneled in here. And I can sit at the top and just go stab, stab, stab. What else can I build? Another crate or two, maybe? Or three or four? Is there a fast way to heal? What does C do? That's character stats, okay. I'm just rather not sit here and listen to that sound for 10 minutes to heal. Hopefully zombies can't come through there. So I don't know what else I have to do now. Journal. Outlast the odds. Ah, survive 5 days. Okay. So this is a part of, I guess, the beginner's tutorial. The good news is it does seem to... Well, I presume it keeps your progress as well. So as I play on, like, these will be done. And it'll just unlock new ones as I come across them, I suppose. Until it covers all the basics. So what's actually happening? It's night time. I've got two dudes hanging around. No zombies to be seen. Still a bit of wood there. Nothing else of interest here. Doesn't look like it. Is it noise again? Ah, okay, that noise is the end of a day, or rather the start of the next day. He's now, yep, 2 days survived. What else can I build? You don't regenerate while you're in the build menu. I literally have to stand here and just wait. Health is 81. 81. 82. Oh, God. Well, this is fun. Is there anything I can use to heal myself? I don't know. Alright, 85 will do. Go for a walk. Well, let's see how this works. Very good. Well, that's a handful of zombies. Another key. Got a little mini hoard on my hands here. Gold, give me the gold. Well, this is doing good numbers for my kill count, that meta progression. What am I on? Day 5. I'm guessing this is just a preview of things to come. As in, this feels like a lot now, but I'm sure this will be dwarfed by the swarm as I progress. Because if this is a roguelike and death is inevitable, I'm sure it's going to just ramp up. So I've got 9 keys. And 117 kills. Wait your turn. I'm actually going to try the Warhammer for a moment. Okay, when Eridorn, Percival, Dimitri, and Odin failed to defeat the terrible lich Necrosarian, Alandra soon fell. The once glorious city is now the home of an undead horde. Perhaps you'll find something or someone there. That's great. This rain is deafening. I do miss having that range. It's a bit slow, but anyway. Probably should chop the wood. Bit more food there. Which I guess I need to be mindful of now that I've got 3 people to feed. Including myself. Oh, yeah, see up the top, my food's down to 2. So, do need to watch that. So, just keep chopping. Wonder how much of this will be in vain. Not sure whether I need to bother or whether death is inevitable and close. I just don't know what the pacing is going to be like. Like, should I be more advanced at this point in the game? But we'll see. Is not bad for crowd control, at least. Could knock back and a few hits at once, which is good. Where else are we going? Here we go, a bridge. Is that a sword? Oh, no, it's a skeleton holding a sword. I thought it was just a weapon laying around. Okay, I've completed an objective, I guess, judging by those coins flying up at me. What is this place? Just an overrun city. Interesting. think I might be in danger, though. Seems to be a lot of them. He's just over there smashing walls. Having a grand old time. Or weapons, maybe. I don't want to get in there and see what's in there. These guys need to leave me alone, though. Weapon, a chest. What about a crossbow? Okay, that's interesting. Or a greatsword. That's actually interesting as well. Start with a crossbow. If it's not weak, having a ranged weapon will be very handy. Whoa. Holy moly, I nearly died. It was hiding behind the door. It's not fair. Uh-oh. Okay, that's no slouch. For some reason, I didn't expect to get a ranged weapon, but... hello? Hit Reg? Hello? I guess that's the downside, is that half the time it won't work. Oh, I need to run back. I have 6% health. Actually, no, I'll keep it out, because if I can keep my distance, it might go a long way to actually surviving. Yeah, I'll walk through a graveyard of zombie apocalypse. What's the worst that could happen? Okay, they're getting a bit more aggressive. And numerous. Uh-oh. Now, piercing arrows, that would be alright. For the gold, just need to rack up these kills and stay alive. Hopefully they won't follow me all the way here. I'm back. I'm healing. I'm down to one food. Uh-oh. Strafe. Uh-oh. Taking hits at my walls on the way in. Right. So they are getting quite aggressive. Do I put a door down, or does that just make them start swinging? Have to see what happens. I do need to sit here and heal for a bit. Just going to pause and spare you the time. Back in a moment. Okay, I've just time skipped ahead. Try and spare you the tedium of watching me sit here and heal, but there appears to be a skeleton stuck at my door. If I let him in, I think I'm going to die. He's got a big sword. Maybe I need something to combat that. This is going to end poorly. Maybe I can open it and dodge through him. Oh, nope. Shield. I'm done. What a way to go. My own little friends over there weren't even helping me. They were just sitting there watching it happen. They're fine. I'm still healing, though. Alright, let's have a look here. 168 kills. That's all? Okay, that's not many, apparently. So as you can see, the last run I had a few points, so I did put one in deep pockets, which just increases the amount of gold that drops. Better get other things. Let's have a look. Increases the amount of storage gained from crates and barrels. Increases the range that items are picked up. Cost 5, so I've got 168. Is that just 5? Yep. Okay, that's cool. Righto, so this can scale quite quickly then. Yeah, and now I've unlocked tier 2. Okay. Additional sources of food around the world. That's nice. That costs 30. Decreases the amount of time between potion uses. Did I have a potion this whole time? Increase the amount of damage done by all NPCs. Okay, so those guys could have been helping me fight. That's good to know. Increases the rate of health regeneration near a campfire. That would actually be really good. Increases the amount of time between hits landed on yourself. So, like, iframes. Okay. Unlocks the ability to choose a class before starting a new run. Righto, now that's Knight's Shield, Rogue's Stealth, or Ranger's Sprint. Nice, okay. So that's how you unlock the classes. Decreases the starting health of zombies, decreases the amount of damage dealt by zombies, decreases the rate that zombies do damage to buildings. Right, so you do have some interesting little paths to choose and how to spend your zombie heads. And these will carry over into the next run and make it easier, and then, you know, in theory, you go further until you reach some endgame stuff. Start with a better weapon, improve potions, that sort of stuff. So, yeah, there's a bit to unpack there. But I'll save that for another time. I'm going to leave it there. Thank you very much for watching. If this game is of interest to you, I'll have a link in the description. You can go check out the demo or wishlisted on Steam. Again, I believe the release date was Q4 this year. And if this is the kind of video you like to see, if you like this and want to see more, please consider subscribing. Helps me out a lot and keeps you in the loop when new videos drop. And thanks for being here. I'll see you next time. Cheers.